thin layer chromatography. TLC is a simple qualitative method used to analyze or separate the contents of a mixture. TLC is used for the rapid analysis of reagent and product purity, or to determine the number of compounds in a mixture. Chemists also use TLC to follow the progress of a reaction by monitoring the disappearance of the reactant or the appearance of a product. Uses of TLC: to determine the number of components in a mixture, to qualitatively identify compounds, to monitor the progress of a reaction, to select an appropriate solvent system for flash column chromatography, a preparative purification method. In our lab, TLC is performed on a sheet of aluminum foil which is coated with a thin layer of adsorbent material called silica gel. The TLC plate is dipped into a solvent or combination of solvents called the mobile phase, which carries the components up the plate based on polar interactions with both the mobile and the stationary phase. The more polar a compound is, the more it will interact with the silica gel and the less distance it will travel up the TLC plate. The more nonpolar a compound is, the more it will interact with the mobile phase and the further it will travel up the TLC plate. Once the TLC plate has been developed in the chamber, the spots can be visualized by a shortwave UV lamp and a TLC stain. Setup: paper towel, solvent, 10 milliliter graduated cylinder, TLC chamber or scintillation vial, tweezers, TLC plate, spotter or capillary tube, starting material, vial of solvent, wooden pencil. When performing TLC, always lay down a paper towel at your workspace. The most common solvent system is a mixture of ethyl acetate, the more polar solvent, and hexanes, the more nonpolar solvent. To determine an appropriate solvent system, begin with a 50% ethyl acetate and hexanes mixture. Add enough of the prepared solvent system to cover the bottom of your TLC chamber equipped with a piece of filter paper. Store any extra solvent system in a sealed and labeled vial. Now, prepare a two-lane TLC. First, using a pencil, draw a single line near the bottom of the plate. This is called the baseline and should be above the solvent level in the chamber. Draw two small lines which will indicate the line where the compound will be spotted. Using a glass capillary tube, spot a diluted sample on each line. Two-lane TLC is performed for consistency. Use tweezers to place the spotted TLC plate into the chamber. Place the cap on the chamber and wait until the solvent has traveled up the plate to just near the top. Do not disturb the chamber. Remove the plate and indicate how far the solvent has traveled by drawing a line. This is called the solvent front. To monitor a reaction by TLC, prepare a three-lane TLC plate. Label the first lane SM for starting material, label the second lane CO for co-spot, and the third as RM for reaction mixture. Spot your starting material on the first two lanes using a spotter. Rinse the capillary tube in a small vial filled with dichloromethane and remove the rinse by spotting onto a paper towel. Once thoroughly rinsed, spot your reaction mixture or product onto the second two lanes on your TLC plate. If your reaction is stirring in an inert atmosphere, thread the spotter into the reaction flask through a short pink needle. Be careful not to break the spotter into the reaction mixture. With tweezers, carefully place the TLC plate leaning against the wall of your TLC chamber. Replace the cap and do not disturb the chamber as the solvent travels up the plate. Once the solvent has traveled up the plate close to the top, carefully remove the plate and mark the solvent front with a pencil. Now it is time to visualize the TLC plate. Place your plate below a UV light to see which spots are UV active. Circle the spots with your pencil. Next, choose a stain based on the functional groups of your mixture to further visualize your TLC plate. Only one stain may be used per plate. we will use potassium permanganate. Using tweezers, submerge your entire TLC plate within the potassium permanganate solution. Wipe excess potassium permanganate stain onto the paper towel and begin to heat the plate. You will see yellow and/or light purple spots form. Heat the plate until you can see all of these spots clearly. Record the TLC plate in your notebook and interpret the results. If the spots are near the bottom of the TLC plate, the selected solvent system is too nonpolar. If the spots are all crowded at the top of the TLC plate, the solvent system is too polar. The goal is to achieve an ideal separation between the compound spots on the plate. When recording TLC information in your notebook, be sure to identify the following: a traced drawing of the TLC plate, solvent system that achieves an ideal separation, TLC stain. Each spot should be labeled with what compound it is, starting material, product, unknown, etc., whether or not it is UV active, and the color the spot turned using your stain. If monitoring the progress of a reaction, indicate the time TLC was performed. If you are using TLC to determine the mobile phase for purification by flash chromatography, distinguished separation between your product and any impurities in the reaction mixture is desired. The distance the spot travels is identified as the retention factor, or RF value, and is what determines a good solvent system. This value can be calculated by dividing the distance, in millimeters, from the baseline to the solvent front by the distance, in millimeters, from the baseline to the middle of the spot. This value should be less than 1 and is unitless. After you perform TLC, adjust to the polarity of your solvent system so that you can achieve ideal separation or an RF of 0.3. To increase the RF, add a higher concentration of the more polar solvent, which in this case is ethyl acetate. To decrease the RF, add a higher concentration of the less polar solvent, which in this case is hexanes. The more polar compounds will interact more with the silica and remain closer to the bottom of the plate than the more nonpolar compounds. To monitor reaction progress, you can see whether or not the starting material is still in the reaction mixture by comparing your SM and RM spots. Once the starting material spot of the reaction mixture has disappeared, the reaction is complete.